Well, most of us pick up a glass or shake someone's hand without a second thought. But for people with a prosthetic hand, even simple actions can be hard to gauge or control. Just think about it. You can't actually feel what you're touching. But as Nicole Ireland shows us, researchers think they've found a way to help.
Rob Anderson fights wildfires for the Alberta government. Almost 12 years ago, the helicopter he was riding in crashed into a mountain.
And in that crash, I lost my left arm and my left leg.
With the help of prosthetic limbs, Anderson was able to get back to firefighting and living as normal a life as possible. But despite technological advances in prosthetics, his motorized hand can only do so much.
I quite often compare using my body-powered the hook as to operating, doing things with a long pair of pliers. You're working at a little bit of a distance, right? There's that disconnect between what you're physically touching and what your body is doing.
That's because if we're grabbing or moving something, we actually rely on the sensation we get from our hand to tell our brain if we're doing it accurately.
You and I, when we open and close our hand and move, our brain naturally just absorbs, you know, thousands of inputs from our skin and muscles and joints. Amputees don't have that. They're disconnected from that motorized prosthesis.
Dr. Jacqueline Hebert has teamed up with the Cleveland Clinic in Ohio, as well as the University of New Brunswick, to conduct a study to try to solve that problem. Anderson is one of her patients and one of six people with arm amputations who took part. When an amputee with a motorized hand thinks about grabbing an object, the hand responds, but the person can't feel it. In this study, the researchers used small devices to vibrate specific muscles in the amputee's upper arm or chest. That created the illusion that the person can sense the movement in their artificial hand.
So we're looking at ways of providing.
The researchers said that can help amputees feel more like the artificial hand is part of them.
It was a very strange sensation to actually be able to feel that feedback, because I hadn't in 10 years.
Feeling the sensation of movement also let the participants move their prosthetic hands with greater precision.
They were able to control their grasp function and how much they were opening the hand to the same degree that someone with an intact hand would.
For Anderson, the technology has big implications for everyday tasks.
I think if you could reach out and touch something with your prosthetic limb and know how much pressure you're putting on it, you know, then you're not crushing water bottles, you're not dropping things.
The researchers acknowledged that they looked at a very small group of patients with very specific types of arm amputations. They're hoping for the next phase of their study, they'll be able to see if this technology can benefit a much broader group of people who use all kinds of different prosthetics. Nicole Ireland, CBC News, Toronto.